secret one. Define goal. We have all heard the story of Alice in Wonderland. While she is wandering around an unknown country, Alice finds herself at a big crossroads. As she was not sure, she stops and turns around, and she notices a cat who is sitting peacefully. Alice decides to ask him for help and asks, "Would you tell me, please, which way I ought to go from here?" "That depends a good deal on where you want to get to," said the cat. "I don't much care where," said Alice. "Then it doesn't matter which way you go," said the cat. John Rockefeller was considered to have been one of the richest men in the world. He gave interviews very rarely and, in general, went to public. Just before his death, he gave an interview to the then anonymous and today one of the most influential world newspapers into the question, "What is necessary for success?" he replied. "I have read many books and met a lot of successful people. Eventually, I have learned that only two things are necessary for success. First, that a man knows exactly that he wants to succeed. And second, that he is ready to pay the price." I believe that a lack of clear goals is the biggest reason for failure in any field of life. Nowadays, when you ask people in the street what is their goal, you often get the answers such as, "I wish to have a kind of normal job. I wish to be happy. I do not know," and the like. If we look into it carefully, we notice that people use the term "I wish," which implies wishes, and between wishes and goals there is a big difference. In his book, What They Don't Teach You at Harvard Business School, Mark McCormick tells a study conducted at Harvard between 1979 and 1989. The students, graduated in the 1979 Harvard MBA program, were asked, "Have you set clear, written goals for your future and made plans to accomplish them?" Only 3% of the graduates had written goals and plans. 13% had goals, but they were not in writing, and a whopping 84% had no specific goals at all except for enjoying the summer. In 1989, 10 years later, the members of the class were interviewed again. The 13% of the class who had goals were earning, on average, twice as much as the 84% who had no goals at all. And what was surprising and astonishing is the fact that the 3% who had clear, written goals were earning, on average, 10 times as much as the other 97% put together. The only difference between these groups was in clearly set goals they had at graduation. Brian Tracy said, "Clarity accounts for probably 80% of success and happiness." Precisely defined goals are like a magnet. They attract us to them and others to us. In my opinion, there is nothing more important than clearly and rightfully set goal. One should follow the SMART methodology. Each word has its own meaning, as follows. S. Specific. Goals must be to the point. M. Measurable. Goals should be measurable. A. Achievable. Goals should be attainable. R. Result. Goals should achieve specific result. T. Time bound. Goals must have a deadline. I. Inspirable. Goals we set up should be motivating. I will demonstrate the above very simply using the following example. Person A defines his goal saying, "I wish to be rich." This is not sufficiently specific and measurable. It is not possible to assess achievability. The result is not clear since richness is a broad term. There is no deadline and there is a big question as to whether the goal set in this way, basically more of a wish or dream, could inspire the person it refers to. Person B defines his goal as follows. On December 31, 2023, I will have $1 million. The goal set in this way is very specifically defined, absolutely measurable. Whether it is achievable or not depends on your will to pay the price for achieving that goal, including hard work, sacrifice, courage, risk-taking, etc. The result is evident. The goal is specifically defined in terms of time and, I believe that we agree, it is above all inspiring. A goal set in this way, by not writing it down as something yet to happen but rather as something already achieved has an incredibly powerful psychological effect since it activates the power of subconscious mind which leads us irrepressibly and relentlessly to achieving of that goal. Before you define your goals, it is necessary to examine, completely honest, your true values, and set up the goals by yourself after having a long and honest conversation with yourself. Stephen Covey said, "Make sure your ladder is up against the right wall before you start climbing." Your goal may refer to one or more life spheres, including career, money, family, spirituality, etc. Clarity is the most important concept in personal productivity. One of the most significant rules in goal setting is to set your goals in writing. Only 3% of people have written goals, and all others work for them. Now I will give you 3 simple steps that will, if followed properly, surely help you defining your goals in a clear way and make probably the first and the most important step along the way to your success. Number 1. Imagine that there are no limits and that your potential is not restricted in any way. Take a pencil and spontaneously make a list of the things you wish to achieve, what kind of person you want to become, what would you like to have, etc. Make the list frankly, following your real thoughts, feelings, and wishes. Don't fall into a trap of re-examining, just let things slide and put down on paper your true dreams, wishes, and visions. Number 2. Now, take another sheet of paper and out from your list write down 10 goals you want to achieve in your life. They should be positive, ambitious, and written in the present tense. Review the list several times until you are certain this is exactly what you want to achieve in your life. Be ambitious, step out of your comfort zone, and always keep in mind during the planning phase that your life is too short to be trivial. Number 3. Now, look at your list and ask yourself, which goal would have the biggest effect on the success in my life? Encircle that goal and write it down on a small piece of paper which will always be with you until you achieve that goal. According to Brian Tracy, only 1% of the world's most successful people do that. This is an extremely powerful formula for defining and setting the goals that you may use for a lifetime. Clear and written goals have a revolutionary effect. They inspire you, release your energy, enable you to overcome procrastination, and they urge you to decisive action. Every morning, reread your goals. The more you think of them, the more they become your internal drive and wish to achieve them. A well-known proverb says, "Goals are fuel to the furnace of achievement." Goals cannot be universal, nobody but you can define what you want to achieve. Just like success, goals are also deeply personal. My aim in this chapter is not to define your goals, but rather to motivate you to define them by yourself, to show you how to do it in a proper way, and to reveal to you a simple, proven, and powerful methodology on how to persist along the way to their achievement. I do hope that you will be able to define your goals following the above instructions and to feel the passion and positive energy deriving from the awareness that you know exactly where you intend to come to. Galileo Galilei said, "You cannot teach a man anything, you can only help him to find it within himself." Secret 2. Get an attitude that leads to success. A young man asked Socrates, an ancient Greek philosopher, the secret of success. Socrates told the young man to meet him near the river the next morning. They met, and Socrates asked the young man to walk with him toward the river. When the water got up to their necks, Socrates took the young man by surprise and ducked him into the water. The man struggled to get out, but Socrates was strong and kept him under water until he started turning blue. The young man struggled hard and finally managed to get up. The first thing he did was to gasp and take a deep breath. Socrates asked, "What did you want the most when you were under the water?" The man replied, "To breathe." Socrates said, "That's the secret to success. When you want to succeed as much as you want to breathe, you will be a great success. There is no other secret." The one point which all motivation authors absolutely agree upon is that your attitude is by far the most important factor in your success. Basically, an attitude is something that you reflect from your inside to the outside world. Your attitude is the way of your general perceiving of the things in your life, but at the same time also the way of your coping with the things happening to you. I am sure that you have heard of the 80-20 rule, called Pareto's principle. Vilfredo Federico Pareto was an Italian scientist who explored the distribution of wealth in his country and observed that in Italy 20% of the people owned 80% of the wealth. After that, many natural phenomena have been shown empirically to exhibit such a distribution.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.